So who's our next applicant? Ah, our two daiquiri men.
So what are we thinking? Dana?
You're kidding, right? No.
Eleanor?
They seem like really nice guys. I don't think so.
Okay, moving on.
Can I say something?
You can. You will. We will resent you for wasting our time, but please don't let that stop you.
It's just diversity is in our DNA, right? I thought the goal here was to find people with a different way of thinking.
There's plenty of people with a different way of thinking. It doesn't mean that we have to hire them.
Very good point, Dana. Moving on.
I'm sorry, but you read their resumes, right? They have more years of sales and life experience than the age of most of our interns. Not to mention, our final judgment is always based on the layover test, right? Who would you rather be stuck next to at an airport bar for a 6-hour delay? The 10 millionth kid who knows that if you shrink, your strength-to-weight ratio allows you to jump way higher? Duh. Or the out-of-the-box thinkers who turn being stuck in a blender into an advantage.
So what's this? I'm gonna taste this choice more. Guys. This is really nice. You gotta think this one, since it's like a fetish. It's something like maybe we need to devote some time to.
I thought about what you said to me the other day about my painting. Instead of half the night thinking about it. Something occurred to me. I fell into a deep, peaceful sleep, and I haven't thought about you since. You know what occurred to me?
No.
You're just a kid. You don't have the faintest idea of what you're talking about.
Why, thank you.
It's all right. You've never been out of Boston.
Nope.
If I asked you about art, you'd probably give me the skinny on every art book ever written. Michelangelo. I know a lot about him. Life's work, political aspirations, him and the Pope, sexual orientation, the whole works, right? I bet you can't tell me what it smells like in the Sistine Chapel. You never actually stood there and looked up at that beautiful ceiling. Women, probably give me a silver, say your personal favorites. You may have even been laid a few times. But you can't tell me what it feels like to wake up next to a woman and feel truly happy. You're a tough kid. When I ask you about war, you probably throw Shakespeare at me, right? Once more into the beach, dear friends. But you've never been near one. You've never held your best friend's head in your lap and watched him gasp his last breath looking to you for help. I ask you about love. Probably quote me a sonnet. But you've never looked at a woman and been totally vulnerable. Found someone that could level you with her eyes. Feeling like God put an angel on earth just for you. Who could rescue you from the depths of hell. And you wouldn't know what it's like to be her angel. To have that love for her be there forever. Through anything. Through cancer. You wouldn't know about sleeping, sitting up in a hospital room for 2 months holding her hand. Because the doctors could see in your eyes that the terms visiting hours don't apply to you. You don't know about real loss, because that only occurs when you love something more than you love yourself. I doubt you've ever dared to love anybody that much. I look at you, I don't see an intelligent, confident man. I see a cocky, scared, shitless kid. But you're a genius, Will. No one denies that. No one could possibly understand the depths of you. But you presume to know everything about me because you saw a painting of mine. You ripped my fucking life apart. You're an orphan, right? You think I'd know the first thing about how hard your life has been, how you feel, who you are? Because I read Oliver Twist. Does that encapsulate you? Personally, I don't don't give a shit about all that, because you know what? I can't learn anything from you. I can't read in some fucking book. Unless you want to talk about you, who you are. And I'm fascinated. I'm in. But you don't want to do that, do you, Spock? You're terrified of what you might say.
From the outside, you took a chance, gave me proof without a goodbye. Now here I am.